Shalom everyone and welcome back to my channel Israel, which is an acronym for Initiative for Shalom Related Advocacies by Exploring the Land. First of all, I would like to express my gratitude for all of your support in making this channel a growing community of learners, and in the process, it encourages me to keep bringing you more quality videos from time to time. So thank you very much. In today's videos, let's take a look at one particular term that we often find mentioned in the Bible. That term is a cistern or a well. We now live in the 21st century, so we might not see it very often in our daily lives. Well, today I'll show you how a well or a cistern looks like.
This is Bor Eitan on the Mount of Eitan. Eitan in Hebrew means strong or large. And today we dipped in this strong and nice water.
I will show you more.
In Brazil, they have the Amazon, Egypt has the Nile, and in Israel, we have a cistern with rainwater.
Oh yes. Inside this cistern is the muddy water, of course, as you can see. Okay, here we are inside the cistern, and this is how it looks. And this is the way up there. Remember, this is Israel. 60% of the country is desert, and it rains only in the winter for a few months. In the ancient time, the only way to have sustainable water supply is either by digging well, or building settlements in a nearby spring, or collecting rainwater as much as possible during the rainy season. If you come to visit Israel, you will find a lot of old cisterns around the country, some dating back to 6,000 years ago. The famous mention of the cistern or a well was in the story of Abraham, and later that well became the name of the city itself, Be'er Sheva. Abraham paid the price of 7 ewe lambs to secure ownership of a well, Be'er Sheva. Be'er means well or a cistern, and Sheva means 7, hence the phrase the well of the 7. Also the same story with Isaac or Ishaq. Isaac also quarreled over a well in Be'er Sheva and named the place the well of the oath. 6,000 years ago, people depended on the well to supply water, but now it's a sprawling tech city known as the capital of the Negev. Look at this dry well in the city of Arad in the Negev desert. As you can see, there's no vegetation, yet people who lived here thousands of years ago survived by digging well to store water. And of course, the famous story of Joseph, where his own brother threw him into an open dry cistern or well. And they took him and threw him into the cistern. The cistern was empty without any water in it. So now you know and you can visualize when you come across such verses in the scripture, how a cistern looks like. A cistern can either be hewn from a bedrock or dug into the ground and later plastered to seal any seepage of water. As you can see from here, this is a typical cistern. Some are very deep and some are not. In the ancient time, they would collect rainwater to be used for their everyday life, but nowadays not so much. Probably just to water some plants or olive trees. Nowadays, people use a cistern just to dip themselves during the hot summer, just to cool them off if they don't go to the sea to swim, just like we are doing here today. Israel is not only a water-dependent country, but also a water-surplus country. How is possible that a country with a very limited resources and most of the country's desert yet able to achieve this extraordinary goal? The answer to that question is God. innovation and technology. No wonder Israel is known as a startup nation. It has surplus water to use inside the country. Now it's even supplying water to its neighboring country like Jordan for 50 million cubic meters a year, double of what it used to be, according to the latest agreement signed this year, 2021, between Israel and Jordan. Just to mention, Jordan is pretty much a landlocked country with very limited sources of drinking water, and it depends on Israel to provide drinking water for its sustenance. Now, Israel uses this water surplus as a diplomatic tool to Jordan. In the past years, the Sea of Galilee, or the Lake Kinneret, the other name of it, was the main source of water supply to the needs of its citizens, because the Lake Kinneret is a freshwater lake, not salty like sea water. Therefore, it's fit for human consumption without the need of desalination. Now, it no longer uses the water from the Sea of Galilee to meet its need. Most of the drinking water supply comes from the desalinated water from the Mediterranean Sea. Seawater desalination is the most reliable source for providing continuous water supply, since seawater is available in unlimited quantities and involves no dependencies neither on climate nor on political factors, thanks to the desalination method invented by Israeli scientist Alexander Zarchin and introduced for the first time in the city of Eilat in the 1960s. So Israel does not need to rely on the weather anymore to procure drinking water to the population. Now Israel has an advanced technology in converting seawater into potable drinking water, and it's fine to even drink water from the tap itself. Also, another breakthrough in producing water from thin air. Israel is lacking no miracle if you look around. It helps a lot, especially for countries facing difficulty in providing safe drinking water. Israeli company IDE Technology is assisting over 40 countries around the world with desalination technologies and continue to be the global leader in this field. So Israel has come a long way, not only in solving its own shortage of proper drinking water, but now through its technology and innovation, it has able to help the world, especially to places where it's difficult to provide water by the traditional method. It's amazing that a small country like Israel is able to bless the world in many ways. Israel continues to be a blessing to the world in many fields, science, technology, agriculture, and more. And do keep in touch for more videos, especially by clicking the bell icon so that you will be notified for new videos. Signing off, much blessings and thank you.